what is forgiveness and how to be more forgiving. Forgiveness. What does it mean to forgive? What is forgiveness? What do we actually do when we forgive someone? First, a little bit of background to let you know where I'm coming from and talking about forgiveness. My goal is to make forgiveness easy, practical, and accessible by everyone, whether the person's religious or not religious, whatever their background, whatever their culture. One of the challenges of forgiveness and of teaching forgiveness in a practical way is there as an aspect of forgiveness that is full of deep mystery as to what forgiveness really is. And that can make it hard to define. However, there's ways around this, and by giving clear, specific definitions of forgiveness, we can use it in very practical ways. And how I think of it is this, like, there's a deep mystery about nature, the forces of nature, nature itself, and the beauty and wonder of nature. And there's some practical aspects of nature that we can understand and relate to. For example, we can plant a garden and put seeds in it and weed it and do what have you. Or we can simply get a plant pot, put a seed in it, and then over the next days and weeks and months, we can watch that seed transform into a plant of some kind, maybe even a tree eventually. So there's ways that we can relate to nature that are practical and specific just by learning to contain it in a certain way. So we don't actually limit nature. We then allow ourselves to actually have a relationship with nature. In the same way, if we define forgiveness in practical ways, that allows us to have a practical relationship with forgiveness, which doesn't take away from the ultimate majesty of forgiveness itself, but allows us a personal connection and relationship with it. Well, there's many different ways of defining forgiveness, and I sometimes do use different definitions myself, but the one I use the most often, because it's the most practical one I've come across, is forgiveness is letting go of wanting to punish. That's it. Just forgiveness is letting go of wanting to punish. Does this work? Yes, it works really well as a definition when you're actually trying to do a specific technique or when you're trying to forgive a specific person for a specific thing and want to have a way of dealing with that issue and moving forward with it so you can let go of the past and move on. There's various reasons why this definition works so well. Basically, it's because it's completely unconditional. When we define forgiveness as letting go of wanting to punish, it doesn't matter if the person's living or dead, whether they've apologized or not apologized, or whatever's going on with the other person doesn't relate to the fact that we can always let go of wanting to punish them. We always have that choice. Since we always have the opportunity to forgive when it's defined that way, then we can always do it. It's always available to us. It's always an option. And the other interesting thing about that definition is when we define forgiveness as letting go of wanting to punish, then it doesn't say anything about the relationship. It doesn't say anything about whether we want to reconcile with the person or not. And this is actually very helpful, because what many people get blocked by in trying to forgive is they're not sure what to do about the ongoing relationship with this person. And maybe that they don't want to have a relationship with this person. They might never want to see them again. They assume that, oh, if I don't want to reconcile, then I can't forgive. And that's not true. Because if we decide that forgiveness is letting go, wanting to punish, and to a very large extent it is that, then what we discover is by working on that and by letting go, wanting to punish this person, we become free. And then what happens is we can make wiser choices around possible reconciliation, because it gets the cloudiness away. We're no longer going to have a state of wanting to be vengeful. We're not so entangled in the relationship. So forgiveness is letting go of wanting to punish. What then is reconciliation? Reconciliation has to do with our ongoing relationship with someone. It's about whether that relationship is possible, because as I said earlier, they may have been dead, they may have passed on, or we might not have seen them for years or what have you. So sometimes reconciliation is not possible. Sometimes reconciliation is not desirable because characteristics of that person may make them too hard for us to be around if they're violent or abusive or what have you. Reconciliation does not need to be part of forgiveness. The decision about reconciliation is a unique decision in its own right, distinct from the decision to forgive in the sense of letting go of wanting to punish. And this brings a clarity and an insight into forgiveness and allows us to engage with forgiveness and explore the forgiveness process ourselves then we discover what forgiveness is for us. And one way of doing that is to use a very specific technique that I teach called the four steps to forgiveness. Whereas forgiveness is unconditional, reconciliation, we sometimes might want to put conditions on it. I've done another video on the topic of tough forgiveness, which is about when we actually want to negotiate, or at least we're open to the possibility of a reconciliation, but we need to talk about some things first with this other person. We need to agree some things first before we'd be willing to go ahead. So defining forgiveness as letting go of wanting to punish doesn't take anything away from the majesty or the depth or the mystery of forgiveness. It simply is a way of making that accessible to us. And that definition works for anyone, no matter what their religion or whether they have no religion. It's simply a practical technique. When we look at the bigger picture of forgiveness and some aspects of that, you see there's a close relationship between forgiving other people and forgiving ourselves. One tends to support the other. And if we are having trouble forgiving ourselves, then it's that bit harder to forgive other people. If we have a feeling about ourselves where we want to punish ourselves, then it's much more likely we'll want to punish other people too, and vice versa. If our attitude towards other people is to want to punish them for when they make a mistake, then we'll tend to want to punish ourselves for making a mistake. Forgiving other people makes it easier to be happier and more comfortable in our own skin. Similarly, there's an aspect of reconciliation that also comes into forgiving ourselves. We need to have a healthy relationship with ourselves in the longer term. So as we learn to reconcile with others, we also learn things about reconciling with ourselves. One of the main things that shows up the quality of our relationship with ourselves is our own internal self-talk, an internal dialogue. Many of us have internalized a voice from either from a teacher or a parent that was very critical of us. And we have this voice running, in a sense, which is criticizes what we do, especially if we make a mistake. So through self-forgiveness, we learn to heal our relationships so that we don't have an inner bully kind of running our life anymore. In a sense, then forgiving other people helps us to heal that inner bully. Forgiveness then for our purposes is letting go and wanting to punish, and then exploring whether a healthy reconciliation is possible with the person that we're working on forgiving. However, we need to do the forgiveness work first, so we've got the clarity and insight and compassion to see what's the best thing to do about the reconciliation. So we need to do the forgiveness first. What many people do is the opposite. They reconcile, and having done no forgiveness work, they get themselves into the same mess again. If we reconcile with someone without having let go of wanting to punish them, it's not going to go well. Sooner or later, the same issues will emerge. Suppressing feelings is not the same as having forgiven someone. Putting up with someone's bad behavior is not the same as forgiving them. Forgiveness happens when you transform wanting to punish someone, and then it shifts a whole perspective on that relationship and also a relationship with ourselves and our relationship with life. When we actually do forgiveness properly, forgiveness transforms our relationships and forgiveness sets us free. I like to say that forgiveness gives us the freedom to stay or the freedom to walk away. It lets us walk away from relationships that aren't really serving us, frees us from guilt, frees us from shame, lets us make choices in our lives where we're not enmeshed and entangled in unhappy relationships. Hope you find these ideas useful on what is forgiveness and how do we forgive, and you find your way to experience forgiveness as something practical and useful and beneficial in your life. Thank you.